In this segment, we're going to talk about a shooting method. Shooting method is a way to solve ordinary differential equations, but the boundary value problems. This is one of the methods to solve ordinary differential equations, but which are where the conditions are given on the boundary. So that's why we call them boundary value problems. So the kind of equations which are solved by the shooting method are of this form, d2y by dx squared is some function of x, which is the independent variable, y, the dependent variable, and also the first derivative of y with respect to x. So, and this particular differential equation will be subject to some conditions at some point x equal to a, let's suppose we call it y sub a, and then y sub b, which will be the other boundary there, the value will be y sub b. So this is the form which we can solve by using shooting method. To give you some idea of what a typical example might look like, so if you could have a beam, let's suppose you have a beam, you are simply supporting it, it's pinned on one side and supported on the other side, and then what we have is some kind of a load being applied. So let's suppose we have some kind of a uniform load being applied. In that case, what we'll have is that the differential equation, which will find the deflection of this particular beam, is given by this. So the deflection of this particular beam under this load Q here, where x is measured from here, let's suppose, is given by this differential equation. So you are measuring the deflection going downwards. Let's suppose Q is the load which is applied, E is the Young's modulus, I is the second moment of area, x is, of course, the location, L is the length. So this could be the length of the beam which you are going through. So in this case, this will be the differential equation. And then it will be subject to, of course, V sub 0 is 0, and V sub L is equal to 0. So you're finding out the conditions are given on the boundary itself. So it does fall under this category right here, because the second derivative is simply a function of just x in this case. It's not a, it doesn't have y terms, doesn't have derivative of y terms in there, but they are included in a way. And then the boundary condition is at one point, which is at x equal to 0 is 0, and at the other point at x equal to b, which is in this case L, is also 0. So that's one example of what kind of problems can be solved by using a shooting method. Let's take a little bit more, not involved example, but one which gives you things which are non-zero. If you have a pressure vessel, for example, and the inner radius is A and the outer radius is B, let's suppose. And you, if you want to find out what the, if you are subjecting this to some kind of a pressure inside, some uniform pressure inside, what's going to happen is that the differential equation which governs the amount of radial deflection which is taking place is given by this. So if R is measured as the radial location, so R is the radial location. So if R is the radial location and U is the radial displacement. So because if you are going to pressurize it inside or outside, what's going to happen is that this particular pressure vessel is going to deform radially, and this is the differential equation which governs the radial displacement of this pressure vessel here. So this might be subjected to U at A equal to U sub A and U sub B equal to U sub B. So you might be given conditions at how much it is displacing at A and how much it is displacing at B. The way you could do that is by simply putting a strain gauge at R equal to A and R equal to B, and then once you're measuring the normal strain, the hoop strain, that hoop strain is directly connected to how much is the deflection taking place at A and how much is the radial displacement taking place at B. But leaving that aside, what you'll have to do is you rewrite this in the form d2u by dr squared is equal to u by r squared plus 1 by r du by dr. And you can see that this is a function of the independent variable r, the function of the dependent variable u, and the function of the first derivative of u, subject to the condition that u sub a is equal to some displacement which is given at a, and the displacement of b is given at u sub b. So that's what's happening there. So this is another example which I am showing you that where you could be asked to, or where you can apply the shooting method. These are the kind of differential equations which you can do that to. Now the question is that what is shooting method in itself, and that's something which we will discuss in the next part. And this is the end of this segment.